How do you sum up a man who lived a life most of us could only dream of, filled to the brim with fun, laughter and love? Well, the answer is you can't. But here is just a glimpse of Jono's incredible ride and what he meant to so many.
I didn't even feel a thing.
Didn't you?
It was like my wedding night.
Jono liked his television live and dangerous.
Come on, doggy! Come on, boys! Come on, Silky! Come on, I got the food here!
And on Studio 10, he was always ready to go the extra mile to land a job.
She has not aged well.
To all my Valentines around Australia, you know who you are. Don't tell my wife.
Jono just made people smile. Jonathan Harry Coleman was born in London on the 29th of February 1956, a leap year. He was still a boy when he came to Australia by boat, a 10-pound pom, he'd joke. Wasn't long before showbiz beckoned. Do you believe
anything can happen? Hi, Jonathan Coleman here with a bit of an exclusive.
Jono got his first big break on legendary children's show Simon Townsend's Wonder World in 1979. A whole generation of Aussies grew up watching his wacky roving reports.
I kind of look slimmer in the comics. Damn jungle food.
Then Jono made the jump to radio. What followed was a decade of dominating the airwaves with his pal Ian Rogerson for the Jono and Dano show.
Lola, we had a song about you earlier on, Lola. Kinks.
I know, I heard it.
Long before Hamish and Andy, Jono and Dano were everywhere.
Stand back, Brady. This could be dangerous.
Oh, mate, how are you, mate? Excuse me.
Then Jono's career went global.
If suddenly there was a threat to this world from some other species, from another planet.
He moved back to the UK and continued to make magic behind the mic, hosting top radio shows at the BBC, Virgin Radio, and at London's Heart 106.2. Jono moved his young family back to Australia in 2006. To him, here felt like home. And in 2013, he found another home, joining our Studio 10 family.
I'm getting a little bit flushed, all this speech about SEX. In our household, we call it making love. Oh. Where do baked beans go on holidays?
Where?
Cairns.
Wow, Jono, you're naked.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. One, the only, Mr. Shannon Knoll.
I want to live, I want to die. Under the light of the great southern sky. Tell me why you ain't
nothing but a day. Tell me why you ain't nothing but a day. Jono, that's not for you. Tell me why I never wanna hear you
say I want it that way. They're all, these are all on board.
Okay, no, you'll crack his head. You'll crack his head.
I want you to draw me. Draw me like one of your French girls, Jack.
Thanks, Sarah.
Just practicing.
Jack Coleman, you've got to be serious.
I am.
Jono was diagnosed with advanced prostate cancer 4 years ago. And he'd been fighting ever since.
There's this cold chill that goes through your body and you start cutting to movie scenes. It's almost just like, oh my God, I just heard the word cancer. You have cancer.
He underwent intense chemotherapy and radiation treatment in Sydney, laughter helping him get through the toughest days.
How much has laughter carried you two through?
Oh, it's very important. The whole family is kind of set very un-PC and very strange, humorous ways to cope, I guess.
Margot, his beloved wife of 31 years, was the love of his life and his rock. He called his children, Emily and Oscar, his greatest ever achievements. His dog Banjo, a much loved and loyal companion.
I want them to experience all the things that I've experienced, and I want to be there for that. And those are the things, that the dark times that get in your mind.
Jono didn't want to make a big fuss about being sick.
Within like 5 minutes, he said, yes, well, I can tell you your prostate is enlarged and there's a sort of a hard lump, so I'd say you got cancer.
He did like to make a fuss of the wonderful people who cared for him at the Kinghorn Centre, St Vincent's Hospital and Chris O'Brien's Lifehouse.
Be honest, what was he like as a patient?
Oh, he was charming.
Oh.
Last year, we celebrated Jono's sweet 16th. Well, kind of.
Jono celebrates his birthday every leap year. Right. So officially, it's his 16th birthday today.
But 6 months ago, the cancer came back and it was more aggressive than ever. Jono was ready to fight.
When I had my chemo, I used to put this on the Fridays. It's a Japanese headband and it means success. So I put that on like that for success with the chemo and put my ice cap on. It's very fetching, isn't it?
When he lost his brave battle, he was surrounded by family in Sydney. Larger than life, with the biggest of hearts, he was so much more than just the funny bloke on the telly. He was an OAM, a husband, a father, a brother, a son, and a friend. Goodbye, Jono Coleman. Our hearts are utterly broken. We'll miss you.